scene that happened a few weeks back, somewhere last month. Before I dive into the story, I want to put in another thing, which is clothing. Now, being fat, or is that not politically correct term? Chubby, a little cuter than others, maybe? I don't know. Being fat, one thing that's very difficult to find is lingerie. And bras, my friends, are my enemies. I have this conventionally perfect roommate who has the perfect size, and she has all kinds of bras, from lacy to not lacy to strapless to straps to, you know, the ones that come out as a t-shirt to ones without clothes. I don't even know what they are called, because all I find are new. But that's very comfortable, but of no use with the heroines and Indian cinemas.
Thank you.
And there was this one hair left. Now, I was smart, right? I should have gotten 2 beers, I tell you. We were like, we share. We had half of that beer. We were like, we go get some for a month. I mean, you're in one way, you're not getting all month. But the problem with this, if you cut me, you can get more month than still. I've had that much all month in my life. But still, I was like, okay, we went down, got everything, small bottle of cold month, started drinking, and then things started exploding. So we started exploring, and it was nice. Everything seemed nice. But there was a point where I didn't like what he was doing. It was more like he was trying to choke me, but I'm not the choke me nanny kind of girl. So I'm like, I don't know what it is. And I said no. And he understood. It was by then around 12:30, 1-ish of time when I couldn't go back on my place. Because taking an auto and going back or taking a cab and going back to that side of the city was much more dangerous than staying in this guy. So I thought, okay, I'll stay back, and again we started exploring and we started going on. And at one point it became some kind of weird role play, like my gently of the sexual assault that happened to me when I was 11. And I was like, what kind of stuff is going on here? Am I too drunk or is it just me overthinking? And all of this happened, it went on smooth. I came back to my room and moved my couch up the next day. I called up my friend and I was like, listen, this is what happened. I don't think it was a good idea. And he was like, then don't do it the next time. I'm like, wrong person, wrong call. Then call the next person. Then call to my room and I'm like, listen, this is what happened. And I should have called him first. It was my mistake. We start talking about this guy and what went wrong and what went right. And that's it. I was thinking, like, why can't I just say no, leave from there? A lot of people would theorize, you would be thinking, or a lot of my friends that I tell them would be thinking, why can't I just say no and move? Like, leave. It was not like he was putting a bondage there. It was not like some creepy guy who kidnapped you. But in the middle of the night, in the middle of doing it, pushing him away, saying that no, and saying no means no, you know, fan of big movie and all of that, does not that make sense? It was much more convenient and easier for me to let it happen, get it done. Go back home, take a nice hot shower, take a day off, order some great food and call up my friends. And I'm thinking maybe I would never do this again in my life. But I told my friend that no, I'm not made for hookups, now it's only one room down. What does this one room down? Please someone give me the guide so that I can find with five great girls and got a couple of hookups. I still don't get to find this one room. Bhagavan got Prida where he speaks about soulmates, and he says you have a lot of soulmates, not just one, and you will find them one day. I don't think I have any, or either he's a philosopher. So, you know, in between all this, all I'm trying to say is sometimes, maybe sometimes, saying no is not the easier choice, and letting it happen is much more convenient. And it's definitely not our fault, or anybody's fault. But many more hookups, breakups, I might come back again to tell another story. Thank you.